Hello there, I'm Josh from Audiophile Heaven and today I'm going a short video review, this time no unboxing, of the Verum 1 headphones. So, those are the headphones, made by Verum in Ukraine, I hope you can see them. Very interesting looking headphones, with this V shape here, which denotes their company Verum. So, those are the headphones, they sit pretty nicely on the head. I don't know if you can notice this, but they give you natural cat ears, like those do great on a Comic-Con or such event, but I think the aesthetics are a bit strange. Anyways, those are planar magnetic, those are pretty hard to drive headphones, they are made very well. I don't know if you can notice this, but they are very good looking, very beautifully designed. They are very hard to drive actually, although they are easy to get loud. They have a very high, very low impedance actually, and they can make your amplifier go into current current overdrive and clip. They lead to a lot of amplifier clipping with a lot of amplifiers actually, which is interesting because I was not expecting this out of $300 headphone. The adjusting mechanism is quite interesting. Those are actually metallic screws. You just unscrew. You can probably see here. You can detach this headband here. So, very, very interesting design. They are handmade in Ukraine by Verum. So, I would guess you're probably watching this video because you are curious about the sound, not necessarily about the build quality. About the sound, they are very, very good sounding. Considering that they cost about $300, this means that they are a direct competitor to something like Meze 99 Classics. I think they overtake Meze 99 Classics quite easily. They are considerably better overall. The Verum 1 has incredibly amounts of detail. Very, very beautiful sound. Large soundstage, both wide and deep. Excuse me, I did it the wrong way. So both wide, it expands good in width and also pretty deep. They have good instrument separation, good layering. They're pretty much a dream headphone if you ask me for the price for $300. There are very few headphones that reach the same detail and overall sound. They are pretty colored in the mid-range, so the mid-range is a little colorful. They have a slightly lesser amount of sub-bass compared to the main bass body. The mid-range is pretty natural actually. They do classical music very well. They do not have any kind of issues in the treble or in the upper mid-range. You can listen to classical, even to more aggressive pieces with complex music, complex instrumentals. You can listen with those very well. As I said, the funny part about them is that they kind of look like this, so I don't know if you can quite see. I needed to do this video with me appearing in it because otherwise I'm not quite sure if you would imagine how they look like. So yeah, those two little things here are at least a bit different from what most headphone companies go for in terms of aesthetics, but I like them. They are fairly comfortable, they are open, but they isolate a bit from the outside noise. They offer about, 10 dB of isolation. I think they are open, they are not closed back, so they are not supposed to isolate very much, but they do a bit. They don't leak quite as badly as a fully open headphone, like Hi-Fi-Man Aria. I think I have it here. So this is the Hi-Fi-Man Aria. Aria leaks quite a bit more. The Verum 1 leaks quite a bit less. I also have Sundara somewhere around here, I'm not quite sure where, but anyways, they do not leak quite as much as other open back headphones, so you can listen to them at low volumes even during at night if you listen pretty quietly. I think they are very beautifully built. You can see the build quality here. I think it is quite beautiful, quite astonishing. The overall headphone feels very solid. I did a drop test on them, so I dropped them and they resisted to my drop test. I think they are a pretty good overall choice, pretty good overall deal. I thank you for watching and I hope you'll consider watching my other videos. Please look for R2D full written review. I think I do a better job of explaining things in my full written reviews. I hope you have a lovely week in there. Bye-bye.